Warren Gatland backed Ireland to push for an historic third Grand Slam after watching Wallace's already slim title ambitions wither away in Dublin on Saturday. Joe Schmidt's men had too much power and precision for Gatland's side, who fell foul of referee Glenn Jackson far too often to mount a serious challenge while their forwards were dominated by a hugely impressive Irish 8. The 37-27 defeat, their second successive Six Nations loss, leaves Wales with no realistic hope of claiming the championship title, while unbeaten Ireland will claim a precious Grand Slam if they beat Scotland and England in their last two games. Gatland issued a tongue-in-cheek apology to fellow New Zealander Schmidt for saying his side kicked the leather off the ball 2 years ago, but admitted his opponent's relatively limited game plan, based around half-backs Johnny Sexton and Conor Murray, is on course to deliver what would only be Ireland's third Grand Slam in history. They are hard to break down. That is the thing about the Irish team, said Gatland. They are not flashy or anything like that, but they are clinical in terms of they are accurate. They keep the ball for lots of phases, and when they get into your 22, they normally come away with points. They are a hard team to break down. They are a good defensive team. They defend quite narrowly and came hard off their line and frustrated us at times. You have got to keep your patience against an Irish team. Be prepared to kick a little bit and stay in that arm wrestle and wait for your opportunities. With Italy and France left to face at the Principality Stadium on the final two weekends, Wales run the risk of their Six Nations campaign ending in a damp squib. They will make a raft of changes to the team to face Conor O'Shea's winless Italian team on Sunday 11 March, with number 8 Toby Faletau in line for a return alongside George North, who impressed off the bench again on Saturday. Chris Farrell breaks from the tackle of Samson Lee Getty. After the opening fireworks against Scotland, Wales have not fired anywhere near enough shots in anger to mount a serious challenge in the tournament. Their forward pack was disastrously underpowered against Ireland, who completely dominated territory and possession but were unable to deliver the knockout blow as Wales swayed repeatedly against the ropes. We need to make some changes against Italy because we want to see where some of the squad is at this level, Gatland said. Can they handle international rugby? The focus changes a little bit. It is important we try and finish in that top three, but also start thinking long-term in terms of the development for World Cup. North's display, along with another hugely assured try-scoring contribution from second-choice scrum half Gareth Davies, provided some glimmers of hope amongst the gloom for Wales. George was good. I really thought he looked dangerous, so it is nice to start developing a bit of depth in those back three positions, said Gatland. It was good to see him get back on the field. He looked dangerous, and on another time he looked like he was going to get through. Having that size and firepower is definitely going to give us another string to our bow. But Ireland were winners by a distance, despite it needing a late Jack Stockdale interception to put clear water between the teams. Sexton, troubled by a stiff back in the warm-up, endured a rare off day with the boot, missing four kicks at goal, although Schmidt, whose peculiar personal feud with the Irish media endures despite his team's continued success, played down the severity of the injury. Murray and Keith Earls, who was excellent again on the right wing, both ended the game with niggles but should be fit for the final two games. Scotland will arrive at the Aviva Stadium full of confidence after their magnificent Calcutta Cup win over England, but Wales also arrived in confident mood and were beaten by a distance. Make no mistake, Ireland look odds-on for the title.